Folks, Bo Sivas here. Welcome back. So, after the little bit of backtracking last episode, we got Shadowheart, a nice little legendary weapon there. And we're ready to continue on now in the Underdark. You want to read all this, you can pause it. If I'm going too fast for you. If I get through some of this fairly quickly, it's because I've been through some of it on a different save. Whoops.
May the darkness protect you.
So I know where some of the stuff is through here. Yo. Or I forget. Wait, I'm using a spell slot, at least for right now.
Watch your back.
Spores. Must be myconids nearby.
About to be a fight.
Yes, here.
Nothing important is ever easy. No hesitation.
Why do that? Thank you. See what he does. Dashing. I take them out without using anything. I hope she don't get knocked off.
I'll strike you down.
Dang, it's Minotaurs, man.
Hope your soul is in good hands.
Forgot to do the accuracy thing. Who lives and dies because they did some damage.
breathing, despite everything.
Damage there.
Gods, what's happening?
You hate your fail.
Slender drow blade impales the stone before you, keeping a silent vigil. This blade was a warrior's sacrifice to Elis Stray. Blood can only be honored with blood. The drow script inscribed on the blade flickers and glows. It rises from the stone, hanging in the air in silent offering.
Lovely little pick me up.
I can keep going a little longer now.
Fuck camp. I think that's a barb sword. Or did something.
Oh.
Critical miss. Frightened, can't move. Frightened, can't move. I'm not in a real good position here. Can't do nothing. He can't do nothing. Anything that is that frightened? No, I do not.
See their chances.
Because he's blinded, is that why he can't cast it? That is interrupted. How's the path interrupted? He's right there. Oh, it's because of the damn blindness. Due to the blindness. Frightened again. God, boy, he don't like Asperian, that's for sure.
Still breathing, despite everything.
Tale for the ages.
need to stay focused. Have to keep going.
At the ready.
Spied on that guy.
Come on, then.
Got to concentrate. Move.
Roll in my favor. Good move.
Okay, man. Damn.
Is that blood? No, never mind.
No, I think I got all lucky considering I wasn't in the best of positions. Hey, and you miss a stone statue. Times this game, man. How can you miss the stone statue? Let's not move. Funny. Wait a minute. No.
There's nothing.
Mutilate them.
Another fight. Let's go. May the gods take you first. Can't give up now.
Yes.
Well,
Varian kicked us on that trap.
Sleep.
Oh, he didn't get it. See if I can blow it up.
Left a trap.
Did you get this one? Nope. You know, other times you can use your thieves picks or tools to get a reroll, and but this you gotta use your inspiration. all that was in there.
Let's move.
Yep, anyway. Once again, we got a camp. Get it all organized later. Memory cards for something. Just the helm. Over the hood. Hey, that's a cool one. Go.
No time to waste.
About to get attacked here.
ripe with magic. The path less traveled.
What's next, I wonder?
I applaud your taste.
Down there.
Step by step.
That is interrupted. Of course it is.
A rough tempest I will raise.
Eat this.
Come on, can't stay idle. No time for mercy.
The hell? Game's lagging. That didn't go as badly as I thought it would. Man, make a comment in the section below. Is everybody just as bad with their dice rolls as I am? And this is normal difficulty. Better know him than he is.
I might.
No time to rest.
No. Somebody might be able to use it. It's. I don't know. Send that stuff to camp. Doing with this stuff.
Well, it ends not as bad as it could have.
There it is. Oh, I'm over there, and there's a way to get down to the front. How? Without having to go out of your way. Ah, crap, I forgot about those.
Creature. Most likely not a creature I'd like to meet.
Here? Wait.
A camp. Looks abandoned.
Curious. go to.
Snap like twigs. Must have been quite a fool.
Perfect ring of mushroom. Pretty, but it doesn't do much. Hiding in plain sight.
Oh, and of course, none of them follow me up there.
My face protects me.
Keep your distance, darling.
I was too high for him. Too high. So all of a sudden it's too high.
What's that I spy?
Oh. Way on going. Oh, now that's too high. How is that too high for him? Nobody else.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times.
Bunch of crap, man.
Another illusion. Is anything real down here?
Bring you back to the bog. There's a path, if I remember right from my other save.
Scorched ground. Better watch out.
It's Wizard's Tower, but gotta be quick. That'll save us from having to go all the way around to the tree. You take a little damage. Oh, for God, how loud.
Don't give up now.
Wouldn't jump down there, but we're at the camp.
You have my attention.
can keep going a little longer now.
Well, that is a way around if you haven't done that yet, or didn't know. Because there are some plants in here. All you need is one.
These flowers. What is this feeling?
Found a perception check for that.
Keep a blade close. A crooked touch.
Looking ahead.
Combine it. It turns everything Now we can explore around there with no problem. Pretty cool. That's just worth some gold. That's that sister tree flower that I just put in there. Just telling you what it does.
Wizard's Tower is his sanctum. Private place for research and respite. But as this wizard's not home, I say we take a peek.
You'll want to get those later. I'll tell you why for now if you haven't done it. If you head this way first, Want to read everything if you want. It has lore stuff.
Seems like the owner was quite the literary type.
Here we want to go out. There's little notes you want to pick up.
How delicious.
You don't have to pick it.
Still breathing, despite everything.
My other grave. Man, I kept getting blasted by those things, running all the way over to the tree to get those sister flowers. And I just happened to catch that at the corner of my eye that you could jump down there. I don't know what these ingots are for yet. Want to pick up these little letters.
With pleasure.
Hammer there, something fell. Machinery. Alchemy. Amazing. Do Healing and religion.
Oh, I have the magic.
You already have two rings. Oh, that's great. What do you got?
No one stopped me yet.
I know what that button does. And if you're curious, there's a dog collar you get out there. And if you're wearing that dog collar, it'll give you stakes. That's it. Alright, these little torn pieces of paper you want to get. Pick those up. Handwritten letter. I don't know if you gotta pick that one up, I don't remember, but I do anyway. There it is. You wanna pick up that engraved Githyanki disc?
Are these Githyanki markings? Lazelle might know.
Going a little too fast, you can always pause them and read them. Lots of stuff to read here. What soul coins are. That one's one you gotta pick up, but I am anyway. I don't remember. The significance over there. I think I got them all. Save it. Just in case the robot kicks my ass. I don't think you have to fight that robot, though.
You sound so damn like a pressure break. Is it the foe or a foul, contemptuous heel?
You know these words. They're from the opening stanza of a play you found in this very tower.
out of love for me, not love for blood and steel. Command as you see fit, my lord. Randy.
Don't get me wrong. I love poetry as much as an ex-wizard, but using it to command an automaton seems a bit self-indulgent to me.
All right.
Maybe I need more pockets.
We have all this broken machinery for alchemy. I think that's it here. A nice little magic ring. We'll get it yet, but if anybody, I may sell it. Oop. So let's go back to Outpost.
Is more dangerous than I thought.
Traps. How considerate.
You know, for one, for those modifiers, my dice rolls are so low all the time. For one, for modifiers, man, I don't think I'd ever have a successful dice roll.
All right, what now? Light on my feet.
There's lots of stuff up here to help get money. Potions. camp supplies. Lots of camp supplies.
Keep your distance, darling. How for a skeleton key?
Stuff. Don't want the rotten stuff.
My. I'd better be careful not to trigger that thing.
Well, hello.
A lot of camp supplies. Alright. Let's use more camp supplies.
Someone there. Hardly a challenge.
Let's move. Let's get up here. Nothing.
Mushrooms down here can't be trusted. Oh.
Babe.
You are swallowed by a chorus of turbulent music. Through one creature sing many voices. The harmony of an entire collective.
Sovereign, she has come. She is here.
The choir fades. A single melody rises above the others, brassy and commanding.
I am sovereign.
You see a vision. Your lifeless body wrapped in fungal tendrils. The sovereign is threatening you.
State your purpose.
Fungal roots weave through your mind, seeking your true intent. Then the sovereign drones a new melody. Cautious, but welcoming.
I can mend neither skin nor spirit, but we still might commune. Descend to me. Let us speak in flesh.
The persistent music coaxes you forward. The sovereign expects you.
What is the creature doing to those corpses?
Don't!
Her condition is familiar. Poison, derived from a wild weed common to the Underdark. She'll need an antidote soon, most likely held by the poisoner.
Whatever that is, I needed it. Why are you helping me? No arguments there. Felt like a hook horror was sorting through my guts. But that cure did the trick. Quick, sharp too.
I thank you for your help, but I gotta get moving.
It hurts.
Gull's garters. Oh, I don't have time for this. My kin need me.
Maybe not. But you are. I need you to rescue my kin. We can pay. We're Ironhand Clan, best artificers in Baldur's Gate. We were on an expedition down here when the Dwergar snatched us up. I got away, but not the others. The Greys have them digging out some old ruin across the lake. Some dusty temple. It doesn't matter. They'll work my clan to death before they ever get near it. Just mining for materials. Nothing unusual. But our work pays well. Help my clan, and we'll make it worth your while. I swear. Thank you. Only wish I could go with you. But here. I nabbed these boots from the Greys when I ran. I'll feel better knowing you're using them to kick some Dwergar ass. I'll mark where I made my escape. And wait here, I suppose.
Not much choice, eh?
The Sovereign's thick fingers stroke the corpse at its feet. A droning melody greets you as the creature turns its gaze to you.
Flesh talker, I show you a memory. Watch and listen.
A violent vision grips you. Dwegar, dark dwarves chopping Myconid remains.
They broke our peace. They killed our young.
The Sovereign's song slows to the pace of a dirge. It is still in mourning.
We laid waste to many, but intruders remain. Lakewood.
The Sovereign's song halts as it measures your worth.
I sense your resolve. You will find Dwegar invaders near Lake's Edge. Cleanse the rot. Destroy them.
I suppose such wicked killers deserve wicked ends.
Deep purples swirl into familiar shapes. Gnomes in mining gear, chased by Dwegar.
The Dwegar Seeker Gnome. It is a guest.
The Sovereign says nothing, but you hear appreciation in its song.
We breathe life into our enemies' flesh. The dead make a fine host for my growing children.
If I die down here, destroy my corpse.
What more would you ask?
The Sovereign gifts you one more vision. A wall of vines parting to reveal glowing light.
Riches of magic and mind. Cleanse the rot, and they are yours. You do the Circle a service. We will await word.
Some of this stuff I've been through, I think I explained earlier, been through this, so I know what's going to happen, but on a different tune, so.
Ah, a visitor. You're a welcome sight, but let us observe the customs of the locals.
The scholar's brow tenses. His voice spills into your skull, the spores connecting mind to mind.
Blurg. Proud member of the Society of Brilliance at your service. Or perhaps not. Your mind is far more complex than that of the fungi. I observed the fight from a distance. Combat is not my field of expertise, but the Myconids handled themselves well enough. My colleagues and I are working to improve conditions in the Underdark. This need not be such a dire, hostile place. It's curious to find a surface dweller here. What has brought you down so deep? A common phenomenon in the Underdark, I'm afraid. Could I ask what you were searching for to begin with? You were infected by an illithid tadpole? It's a miracle you're still intact. You must be worried sick, but have no fear. I have a friend who may be able to assist. Omelium!
I hope this is important, Blurg. My Zirkwood samples need constant attention.
It is. This adventurer has an illithid tadpole inside her head, but she hasn't turned.
No seromorphosis? That's impossible, but intriguing. Are you looking to have it extracted? Open your mind to me. Let us see what lurks within.
As the Meloan's mind pierces yours, the tadpole pulses with power. It feels 10 times its size. Alive, awake, almost smug.
This is most unusual. The incubation period should be complete, as should your transformation. But the larva is infused with strange magic. It appears to be in some form of stasis. No, it appears to be shielded from physical and magical influence. And even without the shield, the extraction would involve severe cranial trauma. It is not ideal. The process would surely kill you. But not to worry. Should you transform, I will happily perform a new examination. A Nautiloid? Fascinating. I have never set foot on one myself. They were our warships during the greatest eras of the Illithid Empire. We ruled the entire astral plane from their decks. The design was lost when the Gith rebelled and ended our dominion. Of course. I am sorry I cannot assist you in its removal. But I have an idea.
Oh, perhaps I should start taking notes.
There may be a way to bypass that stasis. There are many alchemical substances that can influence the mind. I do not intend to shatter its protection. I need only bypass the interference that prevents me from communicating with the larva. A tincture distilled from a collection of rare mushrooms. They have subtle psionic influence. I would require a fresh tongue of madness and Timusk spores. But be warned, in their natural state, both of these mushrooms can be quite dangerous. Timusks cause confusion in those that approach them. The tongue is self-explanatory. My formula will hamper the more harmful effects once the mushrooms are brewed into a potion. Your sanity, however much you possess, should remain intact. These are fine specimens. It will only take me a moment to brew them to proper potency.
Omeluum turns away to prepare the potion, lost in its own musings.
You must drink the entire draught. I can make no promises as to its taste. It will lower the psionic defenses around the lava. If I cannot remove it, I may still be able to tell you more about its origin.
Insight failed.
Of course. Return when you are ready.
I have never seen anything like it. Let's save the game.
I greet you, son child. I was born with a propensity for arcane magic my people despise. It gave me the strength to resist the elder brain. Every waking hour I pushed back against its dire hold. My wizardry empowered me. The moment its control shattered, I fled. Before the colony discovered, I had defected. In the beginning, I had an arrangement with a lich. Excellent company, despite what one would expect. I required brains, he required souls. A perfect symbiosis. But our ambitions eventually splintered. I wished to better the world, and he preferred its rot. So I left his company. And thus, I now feed from those who act against the society's goals. Perhaps the peoples of the Underdark will be less inclined to violence if they comprehend the cost, yes? Yes, although it may be a touch cold by now.
The potion is disgusting beyond description. The only mercy is that it goes down quickly.
Not a drop left. Very good. As the potion influences your mind, you may find yourself acting irrationally. Try and stay focused.
The world loses its edges, its finer boundaries. You are fluid, but trapped like a creature suspended in amber.
Intelligence or wisdom, I can't remember which one of mine is higher. I don't think it matters either one.
Vision, but the void cannot draw you in. The tadpole spasms, seizes. It's fighting the potion even harder than you are. Fear pierces your mind like knives of ice. The parasite digs deeper, as if it means to hollow out your skull.
Well, all of them are the same. Wow, I got a good roll.
The cold blades lose their edge. You are stalwart, turning that tide of fear against itself. The parasite swells with power. More power than you have ever felt before. It surges and twists, lashing out against that which would dare to intrude. The parasite in your mind quiets, pleased with itself.
Omeluum, are you well?
That lava is like nothing I have ever observed before. Its power is unsettling. It holds far more power than it should. For the lava to react to my manipulations in such a way is beyond my ken. Such crude destruction may not waylay a lava like this, but there is another possibility. I possess a ring of mind shielding. It prevents elder brains from noticing my presence. It will not remove the lava, but it will limit its influence, both positive and negative. I would offer it as a gift, but in truth, the ring is priceless. Is there anything you could offer me in turn? Because removal seemed preferable to negation, and I must admit, I was curious to study the tadpole myself. A fascinating topic indeed. What can you tell me?
See if I can get a good roll. Got one.
What a brilliant experience. To feel one step closer to my ancestors is a fine gift indeed. Here, it is yours. May it serve you as well as it has served me.
A pretty thing. And at least it offers us some protection from the tadpole.
Of course, the lava remains. Be ever vigilant of its growth.
How is your more personal research progressing?
Not well.
Moving ahead.
The nutrition my species receives from other minds.
Those rolls went better than expected.
Fleshwalker. Tongue talker. Far you've come. Reach into memory. Tell me of home.
Reveals its own home in reply. A humid cove filled with decaying myconid corpses.
Dwegar destroyed my people. I am a sovereign with no circle. This circle does not welcome me. But I have heard the song. You mean to cleanse the Dwegar rot. I mean to join you. In death, your foe becomes your ally. I will raise it. You may command it. I am the danger, and I am the cure. They erased my people. I will erase theirs. Remain in the Underdark, and I will follow. We cleanse the rot together.
Hey.
Seems the shrooms are letting in more people every day. You see a fella on his own on your way in. Dwarf. Balin's his name. Right. Never mind. My useless husband. Sent him for an errand. It's no surprise he's made a mess of it. Bald, blue tunic, dumb as a stick. Knock yourself out. But don't come begging for coin if you find him. You try to ransom him to me, you'll find yourself skint and stuck with a fat old lout.
Remember what she has. Hand crossbow. And crossbow is what I really want. That's something for Harlack, but I don't have enough cash. Having really enough cash for anything, I could probably sell stuff, but I'll hold off. Hold off for now.
Keeping the old turnip.
Okay, we'll call it here for this episode. Rummaged around the Arcane Tower, made it to the Myconoid settlement here, and picked up some quests. And that's how we begin our bumbling around in the Underdark. So be sure to like, comment, subscribe. Take care of yourself. Take care of each other. And I'll catch you next video.